Hydrogen.
Think hydrogen.
The wonders of hydrogen.
Picture this, a world where cars glide silently on the roads, emitting nothing but water vapor. Sounds like a dream, right? But is it possible? It's not just a figment of your imagination. It's the promise of hydrogen cars. As the race for sustainable transportation heats up, two giants emerge from the shadows. The electric vehicles we've come to know and the lesser known, yet equally intriguing, hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. While electric cars have been stealing the limelight, there's an underdog waiting in the wings, ready to showcase its prowess. Hydrogen cars, with their quick refueling times, are challenging the status quo, offering a tantalizing glimpse into a future where range anxiety is a thing of the past. But are they really the silver bullet we've been waiting for, or just another pit stop in our journey to green transportation? Let's dive in and uncover the truth. Ever gazed at a glass of water and thought, "Could this power my car?" Sounds absurd, right? But that's the magic of hydrogen fuel cells. Imagine a world where the very essence of life, water, becomes the driving force behind our vehicles. At the heart of a hydrogen car lies its fuel cell, a technological marvel. Hydrogen gas, the lightest element in the universe, enters one side of the fuel cell. Oxygen, from the air we breathe, enters from the other. And in between, a dance of atoms ensues. As hydrogen meets a catalyst, it splits into electrons and protons. These electrons, in their quest to reunite with their counterparts, create an electric current. Voila! We have electricity, the lifeblood of the vehicle. Electric vehicles rely on batteries, storing electricity like a reservoir, waiting to be tapped. But hydrogen cars? They're like live concerts, producing electricity on the go, as and when needed. No waiting, no storing, just pure, spontaneous energy. But the piece de resistance, the byproduct of this atomic tango, as protons, electrons, and oxygen come together at the end of their journey, they form water. That's right, pure, drinkable water. No smoke, no pollutants, just nature's elixir dripping from the tailpipe. Stepping away from the marvel of hydrogen's energy production, let's address the elephant in the room, safety. When most hear hydrogen, they're instantly transported to history class, recalling the Hindenburg disaster. But let's set the record straight. Modern hydrogen cars aren't burning hydrogen. No, they're orchestrating a controlled reaction, a delicate ballet of atoms and molecules, producing energy without the flames. Now, storing this wonder gas is an art and science combined. Picture high-pressure tanks, designed with precision, capable of holding hydrogen at pressures up to 700 bar. That's like holding a wild storm in a teacup. And these aren't your everyday storage units. They're engineered masterpieces, undergoing rigorous testing, from crash tests that would make a stuntman wince to exposure to the harshest conditions Mother Nature can muster. But why all this fuss? Well, hydrogen, despite its immense energy potential, is a bit of a space hog. In its natural gaseous state, it likes to spread out, taking its sweet time. This poses a challenge, especially for vehicles where space is a premium. The solution? Compressed gas storage, using advanced composite vessels, ensuring that we pack as much hydrogen as possible without compromising on safety. And for those of you with an eyebrow raised, questioning the safety of such high pressures, rest assured, the focus isn't just on storing more, but storing smart. Research is ongoing, exploring cold or cryo-compressed hydrogen storage, and even materials-based storage technologies. Think sorbents, metal hydrides, and more. In essence, while hydrogen promises a green future, it demands respect. It asks for innovation, for pushing boundaries, and for ensuring that we drive into a cleaner future, we do so with safety as our co-pilot. From the intricacies of storage and safety, let's shift gears and hit the road. Imagine cruising down the highway, the hum of the engine beneath you, the world blurring past. First off, the silence. It's almost eerie. Unlike the familiar growl of gasoline engines or even the soft whirr of electric vehicles, hydrogen cars offer a tranquility that's almost meditative. It's smooth, it's quiet, and it feels like the future. But, as with all things, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. Picture this, you're on a long drive, the fuel gauge dipping lower, and you think, time for a quick refuel. But here's the catch. Hydrogen stations aren't on every corner like your regular gas stations. Planning becomes paramount. It's a game of strategy, ensuring you're never too far from your next hydrogen pit stop. And speaking of refueling infrastructure, it's still in its infancy. While strides are being made, with stations popping up in urban hubs, the network is sparse. It's a growing ecosystem, but it demands patience. For early adopters, it's a bit like being part of an exclusive club, pioneers in a new frontier of transportation. Ah, the million-dollar question, or should I say, the multi-billion-dollar question. With all the promise hydrogen cars hold, why aren't they zipping around every corner of our streets? The numbers. While electric vehicles have been basking in the limelight, with sales skyrocketing, hydrogen cars have been, well, a bit of a wallflower. The sales figures are starkly contrasting. Electric vehicles are selling like hotcakes, with millions on the roads. Hydrogen cars? They're still counting in the thousands. Safety. Remember the Hindenburg? That massive airship that went up in flames? It's been a long time, but the memory lingers. The mere mention of hydrogen often conjures images of explosions and danger. But here's the twist. Modern hydrogen cars don't burn hydrogen. They use it in a controlled chemical reaction. Still, past incidents have cast a long shadow, making many wary. And then there's the energy conundrum. Producing hydrogen isn't as green as you might think. Most of it comes from natural gas and a process that emits a good deal of CO2. So, while the car itself might only emit water vapor, its fuel source isn't as clean. Electric vehicles, on the other hand, can be charged with renewable energy, making their overall carbon footprint potentially much smaller. Lastly, there's the infrastructure challenge. Building hydrogen refueling stations is expensive, and with few hydrogen cars on the road, there's little incentive to invest in them. It's a classic chicken and egg situation. Which comes first, the hydrogen cars or the refueling stations? In the grand race of alternative fuels, hydrogen has had a slow start. But remember, it's not about how you start, but how you finish. As technology advances and perceptions shift, who knows? Hydrogen might just have its moment in the sun. While passenger cars have been the focal point of our discussion, hydrogen might find its true calling elsewhere. Commercial vehicles, for instance. Think about it. Long-haul trucks covering vast distances where quick refueling and extended range are paramount. Hydrogen could be their knight in shining armor, and it's not just a pipe dream. Several companies are already testing hydrogen-powered trucks, aiming to combine the best of both worlds, the range of diesel with the cleanliness of hydrogen. But the hydrogen revolution isn't stopping at trucks. Buses in cities like London and Tokyo are already humming along on hydrogen. And it's not just on the roads. The rails and construction sites are getting a taste of it too, with hydrogen-powered trains and diggers making their debut. Now, the hydrogen evangelists would have you believe it's the fuel of the future, poised to dethrone battery electric vehicles, BEVs, but let's ground ourselves in reality. BEVs currently have the home field advantage, with a head start in infrastructure, public perception, and sheer numbers. But who said it's a zero-sum game? The future might not be hydrogen or batteries, but hydrogen and batteries, each playing to their strengths. It's clear that the road ahead is both exciting and challenging. Hydrogen has potential, especially in areas where electric vehicles might not fit the bill. But there are hurdles to overcome, from infrastructure to public perception. Regardless of where you stand on hydrogen versus electric, the end goal is the same: a cleaner, sustainable future. Both have a role to play in shaping tomorrow's transportation landscape. Thanks for joining this exploration, and remember to stay informed, stay curious, and always look towards a greener future. Until next time.